I'm Dylan John, and welcome to my channel where I cut out the fluff and get straight to the point. Tip number one, let's say you created your video and you have layers of sound effects underneath, and you realize that after watching the video, every medium whoosh sound is way too loud. Instead of having to go through and select every single medium whoosh sound, which is an absolute pain, open your index here, type in medium whoosh, click one of them and press Command A so you select all of those sound effects and hit Control minus a few times to lower all of those medium whoosh sounds a few decibels. Control plus is the shortcut to raise a decibel, by the way. This technique was something I learned from my good buddy Matthew O'Brien, who has a fantastic channel with tons of great Final Cut tutorials. I'll leave his link in the description. Additionally, if you just added a bunch of effects to a video clip and you realize that you need to quickly apply those effects to the same clip or similar clips across your timeline, press Command C on that clip to copy. Type in the name of the clips or a word that's in the name in the search bar of your index. Click this clip below the top one, since the top one is the one we adjusted with the effects. Hold Shift and hit the bottom clip. Then you'll just hit Shift Command V, which is the shortcut to paste attributes. And you'll select all of the effects that you'd like to transfer over to those clips. And boom, you've just adjusted all of those clips at once. Definitely check out Matthew's video because he goes into way more detail on how to use the index. Tip number two I've talked about before, but it is a helpful one. Maybe when you edit your video, you like your setup to look like this. Maybe when you color grade, you like your scopes up with your color wheels and a small timeline. Maybe when you're bringing in footage and reviewing all of your clips, you don't even want the timeline. You just want a huge browser and a decently sized viewport. Instead of having to take the time to adjust your layout and open windows whenever you do these tasks, make your life easier by heading to Window, Workspaces, Save Workspace As, and type in whatever name you want for the layout you have up. Then, whenever it's time to switch to a different part of editing, all you do is head back to Window, Workspaces, select the exact layout you'd like, and now you're all set up and ready to go. No fiddling around with anything. Here's the next tip that has really made my life easier, and I know it can do the same for you. Let's say every time you shoot a YouTube talking head bit, or basically any time you edit your clips, you use the same LUTs, the same wheel adjustments, and you add the same effects. Instead of having to go through the tedious process of adding all of those adjustments every time you edit, adjust your clip once, hit Save Effects Preset in your inspector window, name that bad boy and save it in whatever folder you like. Then, the next day or next week that you sit down to edit, all you have to do is head to that folder in your effects browser and either drag that preset to your clip or double click to apply. And bada bing, bada boom, every effect and every little adjustment that you so meticulously set up the day before have been instantly applied to your clip or clips. You can make as many of these presets as you want, by the way. If you like to do the typical YouTube jump cut where the following shot is scaled in a bit, hit Save Effects Preset, maybe unclick all of the color adjustments and different effects and crop so it's just the scale, rename it, and hit Save. Then you can just double click to make that scale adjustment when you want that zoomed in jump cut to happen. And here's a bonus tip to make your life even easier than it already will be after watching this video. Right click that preset that you use the most and make it the default video effect. Now, you don't even have to take the time to open your effects browser, head to the folder, and click the preset. All you do is just select your clip and hit Option E, think Option Effect, on your clip when you want that save preset to be applied. One more time, that was Option E. Hitting Save Effects Preset also allows you to save audio effects, by the way. Tip number four, let me ask you, how do you personally cut your clip? If you still head to this menu to select the blade tool, then definitely perk up those ears, because I haven't pressed this button since Bush was in office. Senior. Knowing what keys give you access to what features will make you extremely faster at editing, and it'll make you enjoy it so much more too. Obviously, you should know that, for example, the T key is the trim tool, B is the blade tool, A is the select tool, R is range selection,
You can nudge clips by pressing period and comma, and so on and so forth. I actually have a free downloadable cheat sheet that shows all of the best keyboard shortcuts in my opinion, so I'll put a link to that in the description. But my tip here for you is to change what function your keys do to make editing even smoother and faster. For example, instead of having to press Command and B to immediately make a cut, just switch this function to B, so you only have to press one key to make a cut. Instead of having to head to this drop-down menu to select automatic adjustment when you want to slow down a clip to slow motion, just make this a keyboard shortcut, like option backslash. Instead of having to press option left and option right bracket to trim start and trim end, change this function to only left or right bracket. Or for something even quicker, make it G and H. Changing your keys function is pretty easy too. Just press option command K, head to this drop-down menu, and duplicate the default keyboard. Type in the function you want to change, select it, and then press the key that you want to take its place. Then just delete the original if you don't want two keys with the same function, and hit save. The last tip to make your life even easier is to use what is essentially your very own personal secretary in the library browser. Instead of having to try and remember which parts of your clips you really like and think you'll use in your video, hit this button, extend out the clip duration so you can see more of your clips in the browser. And when you find sections you like and think will make the final edit, hit I for the endpoint and O for the outpoint, and hit F for favorite. Not only will you now see the best bits of your clips in your browser just by noticing this green line, but your very own personal secretary has filed those clips or sections of clips neatly away in your favorites folder, which can be accessed in this drop-down menu. Your secretary made sure to only include those best bits you favorited too, not the beginning of those clips and not the end. And if you're further along in creating your video and you're struggling to remember which clips or parts of clips you've already used in your video, hit View, Browser, and select Used Media Ranges. Now your secretary has put an orange highlighter mark over the bottom of all the media that's already in your timeline. Also, a quick add-on tip, to unfavorite a selection, just select the clip and press the U key. Thank you for unfavorite.
If you've watched some of my videos, but you haven't hit that big red subscribe button yet, consider doing so so you don't miss out on any more Final Cut Pro tips and tricks. Have a great rest of your day, guys.